Hi ladies, I wanted to quickly go through a few exercises for you on how to foam roll. These are all basic foam rolling techniques that you can use as often as you want. So nothing specific, just kind of going through every area of the body. So the first one is going to be for your back. Anytime you do any of this, you want to make sure that you're not going too low on the ribs. So you're going to go up into probably like the bra line. Don't go much further down than the bra line. So we're going to lift up. You want to squeeze the glutes because you don't want to have this arch in your back. You don't want that. So lift up, squeeze the glutes, and you're just going to roll back and forth on your back. And if you find any tight spots, a lot of times up in the shoulder blades, you can just sit on it, find little spots, roll a little bit, hold it. If you don't feel anything this way, you can also cross your arms over in front and see if that feels any different. So that's the first one that works into the upper back. Another thing that you can do to kind of, a lot of us have rounded shoulders and are tight through our torso. So you can also, again, keeping that core nice and strong, you don't want to arch your back. You're trying to drop back without lifting your ribs. So we're going here and trying to let our body fall back without our rib cage lifting up. So not this, keep that rib cage pulled back. Everything's in alignment here, and you're just kind of falling back over it. And if you're tight, you'll be able to only go as far as I can go, because I can't go very far doing this. But the goal is, while the rib cage stays down, not open, to be able to open to where everything opens up. Now my rib cage is starting to flare. You don't want that. But that just shows you how tight I am. So that is another exercise you can do. Then you're going to sit on your foam roller. You're going to bring one knee up into this figure four position. In this figure four position, you're going to grab the knee and pull it towards your body. Securely place your palm of your hand and your foot on the floor, and then I turn kind of towards my hip, and then I start to roll out. And the more you kind of pull in, you can pull up into the glute, you can drop over, you can pull back, and then you can even pull, like you're rotating, you know, side to side. Let's see if you can see it here a little bit more. So you're going to be up here. You can be here. You can even drop all the way down there. And when you find those tight spots, just sit on them for a few seconds. Breathe. Trying to release those tight areas. So that is piriformis, good for the glutes, good for the low back if you deal with tight back or anything like that. The next one is into the hamstrings. So sitting on it, sorry, I don't know why the light keeps going in and out, but sitting on it and you're just going to roll. You don't want to roll over your joint, so we're not going all the way to the knees, and you're going back and forth. And if it's too much, you can keep one leg in while you roll. And I like to turn the toe and point it out and then to the ceiling and then turn it in. If you don't feel it enough, you can bring that other foot on top and roll as well. Same thing with a cast. Again, not to the knee. Same exact thing, going through the hamstring, pulling the, not the hamstring, same thing as the hamstring, where you turn your toe out and roll up and down the calf, or you go, toe stays directly up, and then turn the toe in. Now you do need strength in your upper body to be able to lift you up. I will show you a video as well using a tennis ball if it's too much for you. But like I said, you can keep this foot here if it's too much. If you need help, you can do that. Okay? The really painful one is the IT band. So we are laying on our side. I always put my top leg over top so that I can kind of control the intensity of this move. And we're starting up at the hip, and you're going to slowly roll down. Now you'll see anytime I roll, I'm not rolling quickly. You might see people at the gym doing that. I don't do it. It's not the way I was trained. People have different opinions on it, so I just don't recommend it. This hurts a lot. Again, you're not going all the way to the knee. You're gonna go to right about there and then back up again. If you find spots, you're gonna sit on them. And like I said, this really hurts, and you'll probably find spots that really, really hurt. If it's too much to handle, just don't roll on them for too long. It hurts me, sorry. And then the other one is your quadriceps. So now you're going to lay on top of the foam roller. Again, don't go to the knees. And the other thing that you need to make sure that you're doing is your core needs to be nice and tight. So think of yourself like you're in a plank position, pulling the belly button back to the spine. Not this. We don't want to arch back. Pull it up and rolling the quadriceps. And just like with the hamstrings and the calves, I like to do my toes in different directions. I turn my toes out and I roll up and down. And like I said, if you find spots that hurt, you can sit on them. Don't worry about that. And then from here, toes directly under, and then turn the toes in. So those are the basic ones. I do have some more upper body ones that, oh, there's one more. Sorry. This is a really good one too. Take that. So now we're angling. It's not straight on like that. It's angled, okay? And you're going to put your leg down, and this is another one that hurts a lot. I bend my knee and I just start to roll up. Ow, sorry, it hurts. And then just roll back down and then roll. And my, it's hard to tell, but my back leg is nice and straight. And then I'm just rolling. But this has to be angled with like how your body is angled, not how your leg is angled. You don't want it straight up and down. You want it, you know, angled. And that is it. So go grab your foam rollers and get to rolling, ladies.